Alright, let's see how fast he melts with this stuff. Definitely faster. This is with everything equipped, but yeah, he's not even gonna get a chance to turn around before he dies this time. I bet it's gonna take a long time to find a higher damage weapon, but that's exactly what we're going for today. This thing does up to 36,000 damage on a regular hit. And there's definitely a few things I'm gonna be chasing today. One is a claymore that's a very high level, or maybe very high level fighter's bindings, or even another guardian bow that does incredible damage. And whatever better armor I find along the way, it's just gonna be a lot of grinding. And for most of it, I'm just gonna be running past everything with my fancy purple robe because it's faster. Having this cooldown armor with deflect actually makes a world of difference, because the only way I ever do take damage anymore is really from the arrows, and if 60% of them bounce off of me, it's that much easier. So this is definitely one of my favorite finds I've ever found, and it's only level 105. Plus it just looks good. If I have any luck, I'll be rewarded on my first run of the day with an ember robe, which is probably a pretty decent find, but not helpful for damage. It does have the artifact cooldown, which could be good. It has cowardice, it has surprise gift, all sorts of things that I like, but not what I'm after. I will, however, stop and kill an enderman whenever I find them, even if it means dealing with double damage idiots. Because they don't always drop something good, but I'll take any chance I can get at this point because it's gonna be a long day. Every time something shiny drops on the ground, I get distracted and die. It's just a dancer's sword, but it is at least another unique, and I can never have too many of those. This is exactly the kind of hallway I was talking about when I said deflect makes a world of difference. And interestingly, not having that fourth cooldown enchant doesn't really make a difference. I can still be moving at full speed all the time anyway, basically. As for this guy, can potentially drop me the armor I need. He's probably not going to, but at least he's pretty easy to kill. And reinforced mail 108. While I'm at it, I'm also gonna try and find a harp crossbow from time to time. Lightning crossbow. Oh, not quite the one I wanted, but not a bad start. It's the wrong version of the unique, but it does already have ricochet, plus accelerate, plus multi-shot, plus chain reaction, so this could be a lot of fun. And we're gonna find out if it is or not. Because it has multi-shot, it can still fire lots of arrows, up to 15 at least at once. And it gets faster and faster as it goes, plus they can ricochet off things and multiply once they hit things, so yeah, that could be fun. And it does no less than 3600 damage per volley. Also, I don't know why I'm finding so many unique bows lately, but I'm gonna try and find a guardian bow while the luck is on my side. And that means a lot of pumpkin pastures. I also want to see how this bow does against a large group of enemies, so we'll start firing it in that direction and hopefully nothing touches me. Keep in mind this is just with generic armor that's not any damage boost of any kind. Seems to keep them all at bay pretty good. Not sure what's going on off screen, but I assume there's a lot of damage happening. Yeah, a few stragglers wandering in from the side where they weren't being hit, but I think I'm gonna like this bow for clearing out large groups. And I kind of want to see how this bow is going to do against this boss. Especially when I combine it with his armor, which gives me 30% damage here and another 40% damage here. And some fireworks also, just for good measure. Alright, boss is coming up, let's hit him with that. And, okay, first hit was pretty good, I gotta remember to actually continue to click and not charge up a shot. Well, not the quickest we've seen him die, but still very quick, and he didn't hit me, so that's important. At least so far through all my grinding, I'm finding enough stuff to keep me halfway entertained. I think I can make this jump? Nice. What does it feel to be stuck on that side, idiots? Can you believe we've already saved up another 3,500 emeralds? Boy, time really flies when you're having fun. I'm really just hoping this rewards me with another fun item that's gonna entertain me for the next hour because I'm starting to get bored. This blacksmith is so happy I exist. We found Voidcaller. Pulls enemies in, is plenty fast, has power. We'll hold on to that. We won't use it now, but that might be fun later. Over 3,000 emeralds, only one unique. The game tricked me into thinking tonight was gonna be fun. Alright, well, back to the grind. I'm gonna go back to running a secret boss a few more times because not only can he drop me a weapon, but he could drop me a few artifacts. It could also be a pretty good upgrade. Even with this crazy fast attack speed, he still takes a second to kill, and that's annoying because this is gonna add up to a lot of time, especially when he rewards me with soul crossbows. But seriously though, he dropped me a 113 Gong of Weakening, which is much better than my 109, so that is out of here. And that probably actually did quite a bit for my gear score. Although realistically, I'm not sure it's gonna make any difference at all on my damage output. Many exciting runs later, and we found an imploding crossbow. Not at all what we wanted, but at least it's a unique. And it barely even has enchantments on it. Also, one of the things I'm looking for is simply a mushroom. I've run this I don't know how many times now, haven't found a single one. At least when I have a strength potion, he drops fast. And there's a unique claymore, but not quite the one I wanted. Might still be pretty good though. It's definitely not bad, considering it has radiance to keep you alive, something like committed to do extra damage, critical hit, or swirling, plus say gravity. I kinda wanna build it, so I'm gonna do something painful and get rid of my beloved harp crossbow that I haven't used in forever anyways. There's my mushroom, 80 hours later, level 111, so that's a big upgrade. At least from a gear score perspective, considering it does 13.8 seconds duration, my old one did 13.5, so we're getting an extra 0.3 seconds out of this bad boy. And this claymore seems to hit pretty hard, but not outrageously. There's 22,000 on a basic critical hit. If we hit it on the last hit, that'll be about 40,000 damage, which is similar to my staff, which is a lot of damage, but nothing too outrageous. And now if I equip all my higher level gear, that puts my gear power up to 110, which is pretty high. I think we can get it at a max of 113, and that's going to be a crazy amount of effort, but that's awesome for now. I think that claymore is hitting for 39,000 on its highest hit. This is hitting for 36,000, so the claymore does technically do more damage. The next weakest link in my arsenal is armor. I need better mercenary armor, but it would be great if we could find a less annoying level to get it from. Doesn't look like we have an option. Beggars can't be choosers, back to the fiery forge. At least it has a boss fight. And we can see for the first time ever what my gear score of 110 looks like against these enemies. Gotta pick the less annoying level to do it on, but we'll be fine. Lots of arrows. So far so good. Lots of damage. Most things are dying pretty quickly. As long as I'm not getting hit by too many arrows at once, I think I'll survive. Sometimes it is fun to not run through a level and smash everything I can along the way, just to, you know, take out some of my frustration. And I guess this does have a slightly higher chance for some better drops. Maybe we should also try out my new claymore, since it's built and the same level as this staff anyways. It might do more damage overall. But to give it a fair comparison, we need to go like this and activate everything as we go. That way we really see the potential damage. On this guy, there's 14,000 for a regular hit. Yeah, it's pretty good. We'll switch to the claymore and see how that compares. Who doesn't like a big sword? And its final hit, it's definitely slower, but it's still doing enough damage to pretty much kill everything very quickly. The slower attack speed definitely doesn't do a lot for survival though, because I need lots of hits for radiance to save me. But let's try with everything. Here's a hit for 44,000. Once everything's on anyway, everything's just too easy realistically anyway. And a strength potion, so there we go, lots of red damage. But for those of you that ever wondered what a level 110 claymore looks like, well, this is it. Next, I think I want the armor. And if I can't get the armor, I will settle for fighter's bindings or one of the swirling axes that I like so much. But I'm making a ruling right now. I'm going back to my staff. I need the survivability of this. Plus, I do extra damage at full health, so the more radiance I can have going, the more damage I will do. Mercenary armor, but it's level 105 and very basic. While I'm running this dungeon, I might as well do the rooms like this. They only take a second and reward me with a chest. And again, if I use my power-ups, it's kind of fun. I keep forgetting I have a really good bow too that fires the explosions everywhere that kills pretty much everything one shot. Here's an evoker, which is the boss of the very first level, I think, and I found an imploding crossbow. That's like the 8th one of those that I've found. That might actually be what I'm using now. Oh, turns out it is, and it's actually pretty good. So maybe one with multi-shot wouldn't be the end of the world, and rapid fire and chain reaction. That's actually very similar to the one I'm using now, but instead of having ricochet, we'll have multi-shot, so we'll get a much better crossbow. 3 less levels, but I'll deal with that. We just need to sacrifice something, and I really don't want to sacrifice my guardian bow because this hits so hard. For this new claymore of mine, we'll get rid of that. Then we get our new bow to play with. Yeah, I'm gonna like this one. I can tell already because it fires a lot of explosions out, which can then turn into more explosions, and if they do, basically everything's dead. For example, yep, that's one shot. Here's a good test of what the bow can do, a redstone golem, and some enchanted things behind him that are hurting a lot. But every time I hit him, I do a lot of damage, and these guys are really tough on this difficulty. And he'll reward me with rare mercenary armor, which is getting closer to what I want, but we're still not there. I really do like this bow though, and these sometimes are the best items you can find, the ones you don't expect to find that just turn out to be really good. Alright, I put my archer's armor on because I want to see how quickly we can kill him. We took off half his health with the first shot, so that's quite a lot. And then, yep, not the strongest boss in the world, but still a serviceable bow. What would be a really cool build is a bunch of cooldowns like I have mixed with ranged damage, so I could just run around and fire a bow every once in a while to kill a whole bunch of enemies. That way I'd still get experience, maybe a few emeralds and a few drops. And since we have another 3500, let's hope we get lucky. So lucky in fact, I found 0 uniques. I kind of forgot about the dual crossbows, because they fire 2 projectiles. If you had multi-shot on that, that would fire 10 projectiles at once. They're not super quick, but if that was 5 and 5, that's a lot of damage going out. Dual crossbows can be found in a secret lower temple, and this does have a lot of chests, so let's give it a try. But I'm also mostly just gonna run right through it. I didn't realize that was the end already. I didn't find any items. I just found this longbow, which was really close to a really amazing bow, because it has power, multi-shot, and supercharge. It's just I needed supercharge over here. Here, and this might be the highest damage bow I've ever had. Maybe. Even if that one is 108, that might be able to one-shot the mushroom boss, but it might not. It's gotta be close. I just found gauntlets again, but they're soul fists again. But a bit fighter's bindings. And they're not bad overall, but nothing I'm gonna use. I've just tried something that's gonna make this process a little bit faster. I've been hearing for a while now that there's an exploit that can get you through the door without solving the puzzles. And I was assuming they had patched it. But as it turns out, you can get right on through the door without having to do anything, and that's much faster. So now I can run this chest again and again and again. And from here, since there's nothing I want at the end of the level, I exit straight back to camp. The way I'm doing this simply is clicking on here at the same time I'm pressing attack on a controller, and it puts you on through. I've heard there's a few different ways to do this. I don't know. I've tried it this way. It still works. I'm happy with this result, so I'm gonna keep doing this until I get what I want. I found something legendary. Actually pretty good, because radiance or sharpness, swirling, and critical hit. And again, soul fists, the gift that just keeps on giving and won't go away. There we go. I don't even have to look at these, hover over these to know what they are. Fighter's bindings, 112. Oh, I think 113 is the max, but I'll take 112. Very unfortunately, they don't have radiance, but they do have critical hit, rampaging, and probably echo would be the last choice there. Instead of rampaging, I might do gravity, because gravity works nicely with these. It draws everything in and they die. And they actually do quite a bit more damage. These do 692, the older ones did 520, so that's actually a pretty big increase. So let's give these new ones a try. You know what? I might use these more for fighting bosses, so I'm gonna try rampaging. 10% chance to increase your attack speed by 50%. They're already pretty quick. If echo had a better cooldown, I might use this, because even more attacks getting in there, but on a 3-second cooldown, it's not worth sneaking in a low damage hit. So shockwave it is, an extra 2000 damage every fourth hit, I believe. So let's go see the mushroom boss and see the difference these make. Starting maybe with just some generic cows. Yeah, I can actually notice the damage difference. They're not going to keep me alive as well as the ones with radiance, but the damage is noticeable. And I'll have a gear power still of 110. Alright, let's see how fast he melts with this stuff. Definitely faster. This is with everything equipped, but yeah, he's not even going to get a chance to turn around before he dies this time. I like what I've done. I just watched the replay and realized that rampaging didn't activate, and that's because it happens after defeating a mob, not while you're hitting things, so that was maybe a poor choice on my part. Then again, that still might come in handy because there's usually mobs around the bosses. These do work good against regular mobs as long as nothing's hitting me back too hard. Look, we have rampaging activated. Look how fast I'm attacking. But these hit back sometimes. I just found something called a nocturnal bow, but I can't really stop to take a look at it right now because there's a lot of stuff going on that wants to kill me. The nocturnal bow steals speed, which could be interesting for a build like I have when I'm just all about going fast. But if it's not damaged right now, I'm not interested. This may sound a little weird, but I have to wait to kill you because I need a potion to spawn. And of course, it's gonna play hard to get because I screwed up this process. All I want to do is test my damage against this boss, and I can't get a strength potion no matter what I do. Alright, I finally got one to spawn, now I gotta kill the rest of the enemies and drink them, then attack the boss. But actually, if I do this right, I can get rampaging going if I hit these guys enough times. You know what? Let's just go for it. He doesn't know where I am right now. Let's surprise him and melting. Not as much damage as I thought. He's definitely tougher than a mushroom boss after all, and he's gonna hit me enough times to actually kill me, which is not a good thing, but I don't have any radiance on and there's nothing we can do about that right now. Uh-oh. I never realized how much tougher he is than the other boss, unless I forgot to activate something somehow, but I don't think I did. Anyways, we'll take care of him nice and easy now, though the damage did go down faster that time. I wonder if I missed doing my gong that entire time. I just watched the replay, and I did activate the gong, but I'm not sure it hit him. I was a little ways away, and I didn't see the purple cloud over his head, which might explain why he didn't melt as fast as he normally would. And that's alright, because these things are awesome. They do tons of damage, and I still can't wait to find out what more damage I can do somehow.